Aleluia. Before I say anything, I first wanted to say the organizers, the future belongs to where? Young people. I see hope. I see progress. I see a lot of things. And young people. So I just want to say that before I say anything else, that you guys have done a remarkable job. I'm so happy to be here. With that said, I just wanted to announce that there is going to be a project. The project will be called, it's a speaking project. The project will, we're going to engage, we're going to partner with colleges, universities, and you know, any other people that wanted to help, you know, young people, old people, people in general, humanity. The project will be to uplift, to inspire, to educate people, because we do have a lot in common. You got to understand your culture. Other people need to know your culture. Why? Because we learn from one another. We need to know from our culture as well. This is how civilization spreads. So I just want to make sure that I tell you that this project is going to be sponsored by SpokenStory.org. It is going to be the rule of everyone. With that said, I wanted to introduce Abdul Nasir. Abdul Nasir will tell a story. He also introduced the project as well. He's also my partner. We've done work together. We're going to be engaged in this particular project. Abdul Nasir, welcome. He's a man that, just like all the young people, that have done a remarkable job. He's a guy that I know the most. Not one of them. How's everybody doing tonight?
Good.
I was asking about this event compared to Minnesota. Anybody from Minnesota here? None? It's a problem. All right, I'm going to demand two things. One is that you give me full attention. Two, you laugh at my story, though it's not funny at all. And here's the reason, because I'm gonna miss this event because I've seen the one in Minnesota. Alright? I'm gonna tell you a story about the importance of education. And the title of the event or the story is Learn So You May Understand. I apologize, I have a sore throat. So once upon a time, a grandfather takes his grandson to the mountain for a walk. It was a beautiful sunny day. And while walking on the top of the mountain, the sun falls. And he cries. To his surprise, he hears the same thing from the mountain. The little kid is confused and doesn't understand what's going on. So he says, "Who are you?" To his surprise, he hears the same thing. "Who are you?" The kid goes on and says, he hears the same thing again, and he looks to his father, his grandfather, and asks, "Father, what is this?" And the father replies back by saying, "My grandson, please pay attention." This time, the little kid changes his tone and rhetoric, and he says, "I love you." And he hears back, "I
And the grandfather explains to him what's happening. And he says, my grandson is what people call Echo. But reality, the learned, people that learn, they call it life. L-I-F-E, life. Because in life, you get exactly what you do or say, perfect proportion, not less and not more. So we shall all learn so that someday we may understand, so that someday we may be able to rebuild our country, so that someday we may be able to have a better life.